Well, we're celebrating Fashion Week this week at ShopNBC, so you're going to see a lot of fashion shows, but that also means we still have room for some of our other favorites, Stuhrling original timepieces. Actually, there are a number of ladies' pieces that you can see as well, and many of you actually, if you're really going for fashion, ladies, you're wearing the larger watches. That is still the big trend for women, wearing men's timepieces, so you'll be seeing some of that in the show. I'm going to give you a heads up on a few of the watches before we get started. Boy, my host pick yesterday blew out of here quickly, didn't it? Remember that Tuskegee Flyer XL that we had? Sold out in mere minutes. Well, this is similar. This is the Tuskegee Bomber. Brand new today. New colors are available for the first time. Orange and yellow. $83.50. I do not anticipate that to last very long. Yeah, you weren't here at like, I don't know, what was it, 5 in the morning yesterday? You have no clue what I'm talking about. But it went very, very quickly. Then we have the Montre de Poche Limoges pocket watch. Love this piece. It is the only Stuhrling pocket watch, one of only a couple in our entire inventory. All mechanical movement for $143.25. V91509. And actually, from there, later in the hour, we're going to get into a very sporty look. So we've gone through several different styles and types here. Surprise price on the Apocalypse XT skeletonized, blue and black. Yes, both choices there. $194.12. First payment is going to get that one home of $64.71. So, 2 hours. It's been a busy day, I know, for watches. We're not done yet. One thing you might want to check out is the ShopNBC credit card and apply for that ShopNBC credit card today. Open a card, make that purchase of $25 or more, and you're going to get a $25 statement credit back on that first statement. Kind of taking care of that for you. And you can apply for it online at ShopNBC.com. There's our website. Scroll down to the bottom right there, bottom right. Click on that little credit card-looking icon, and that takes you to the next page where you can decide which card it is that you want to apply for, regular one or the ShopNBC MasterCard. As I said, it's been a very busy day. Tim had a great run with Larry this afternoon. Larry Magen from Stuhrling Original Timepieces, for those that don't know, is back with us for a couple hours on this special Sunday night edition.
Well, here we go, Shawn. Once again, you kicked it off last night, and now I'm back here with you tonight at 1 o'clock in the morning on the East Coast. But now I feel like we're really getting started because I'm now with you, okay? I have the most fun with you of anybody, really, Shawn.
You do not. No,
you know I love working with you. So, and we've got a great lineup tonight, Shawn.
Yeah, well, honestly, we do. And that's what's most important to you are the watches that you're going to see. We're beginning with the Monterey Bay automatic here. We have 1, 2, 3, 4 choices here. And as I did last night, I'm just going to kind of point out which ones are which here, first of all, because there's some variables, but you're ordering based on strap and dial. So the first one you're going to see is green and black. If you like that with the white accents there, you're ordering green and black. The second one in with the orange hour markers and the blue kind of an outer track, that one you're ordering under black and white. So that one is black and white. The third one that you're going to see, which is going to have some blue touches on it, you're ordering that one under blue and black because of the blue rubber strap and the black dial. The fourth one I have is very straightforward. It's black and black. Black dial, black rubber strap. But this is going to have some white accents. So again, those are the four choices, and your customer representatives can help you out. And of course, the website, ShopNBC.com, is the easiest way to see all of these. But Larry, we did. We blew through a ton of these yesterday. I misspoke again because I keep looking at this card here, and it says automatic. It's not an automatic. It's a quartz movement in this one.
That's correct, Shawn. It is a quartz movement. I think one of the executions, I think there were five, weren't there? So maybe one of them.
Might have been.
But so the thing here, this is our Monterey Bay, and this is from our Concorso series in our Sportsman's Collection, one of our more popular series. We have maybe 8 or 9 different models in the series. But this one, I think, is a great choice because it's new for 2010. We went all the way up to 46 millimeters now from the original 44 to give it that new contemporary feel. Everybody's liking them bigger now. But this look is a race-inspired look, and now with this, you know, Swiss movement with the three-hand quartz movement in the different color executions that we've done, it's a great way to get introduced not only to the series but to Stuhrling Original overall. Mm-hmm. You've got the nice rubber strap with the tire tread. It's got that serpentine pattern going down the center of the dial. Here's a nice look at that tire tread-like pattern on the silicone rubber strap. And we always use a very high grade of silicone. These are all custom molded straps, as you can see right here. But again, you may recognize this look, Shawn.
Oh, yeah.
You've got the Arabic 12 and the Arabic 6. You've got the bullet indices that are all individually applied hour markers to the dial here. But this is a very well-known look in the watch industry for quite a number of years now. made famous by a very high-end Swiss brand, but a lot of companies are doing a look similar to this now. And like I said, we've got about 9 different models.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, absolutely. I think so. It certainly seems like it. And here there are 4 choices in this particular execution. And they all are going to have, as Larry pointed out, a Swiss quartz movement. Going back to the price, it's $67.26. You're getting in on a timepiece with a Swiss quartz movement, so that is pretty nice, pretty straightforward, easy to read watch, which is very, very nice. You do have a magnification bubble over the date display at 3 o'clock, makes it just a little bit easier to read. Now, and we had this debate last night because Larry brought it up, very famous Swiss name behind this watch.
Yes.
Not behind this, behind this style, although certainly Stuhrling, a very famous name. Because I was first saying, you know what, casual wear, weekend wear, all that. And Larry said, you know what, though, Shawn, I would ask you to think twice about that.
That's right.
And I'm serious, as I was driving home, I was kind of replaying that conversation in my head, and I'm on board now, Larry. You know what? You're right. This mm-hmm. is one that you could get away with dressing
well,
up.
Well, you know, if you saw the original that this is inspired from, that would sell you in a heartbeat because, yeah. you know, you pay tens of thousands of dollars. Although they do have some models that are below 10 grand, but they can get, you know, seriously up into 5 figures. In any case, though, this is a great everyday timepiece. And if you've never owned a Stuhrling original, never, I want to speak to you because you will be blown away when you bring this home, because do not let the price here fool you, because there is a tendency to associate quality with the price. And usually at this kind of a price point, you might pick up something, you know, walking through a mall at one of those kiosks or something like that, that will come nowhere near this quality. This case is blanked from solid 316L stainless steel. It's not an extrusion case. It's not a cast case or anything like that. You'll be able to feel the heft. It does have a Swiss movement in this timepiece. This is what Stuhrling Original is all about, Shawn. We're all about respect. Mm-hmm. Respect for the art and tradition of the Swiss watchmaking legend. And again, I want to speak to new people out there. Now, for those people that are very well aware of Stuhrling Original and who we are, and you have many Stuhrlings, we refer to you as Stuhrling Nation. Well, you know, listen, if you're in a what we call the NBZ, the no-buy zone, yep. because maybe you've got 20 watches on value pays right now or something like that. Well, here's a little something just so that you can participate tonight and not really break your NBZ here, but just put your toe in the water to get a nice new watch, because you will really will love this. This is a great surprise price, Shawn.
It's a phenomenal surprise price. 3 value pays are tossed in as well, so that means, Larry mentioned value pay, first payment gets us home, $22.42, guys, so very little money to get this home. And of course, now the next big holiday, Father's Day, you're probably thinking about. Here's a great gift for Dad. June 20th is Father's Day, so a month and 10 days or so.
That's correct. And, you know, the one that I'm showing on my wrist. You know,
I like that one.
Well, I love it, too.
Yeah,
and,
I like that
you
one.
Know, the thing is, people who see the shows and follow the Stuhrling shows and everything, everybody knows, you know, once a Bruin, always a Bruin. I'm a UCLA Bruin. Now, the reason I bring that up is I know there's a lot of guys out there that like to buy their college colors. Well, this has got the blue and the orange. You see the outer chapter ring, the minute track, is blue. You see the hour markers and hands is orange. Well, if you're from Florida State.
Oh, yes.
No, not Florida State, but I'm sure, excuse me, strike that. Not a Seminole, but I'm talking about the Gators.
Yes.
Jacksonville. Florida Gators. Here's your colors. New York Mets, orange and blue. Now, by the way, if you want the orange and blue, you're going to order black and white. Now, you know, Shawn explained that brilliantly
I hope we made it clear.
At the top of the presentation, it's going strap color dial. So you do have a black strap with a white dial. So they're calling this one black and white. But this is your orange and blue execution, Shawn.
So, and your customer reps can help you out. 46 millimeter case diameter, 50 meters water resistant, Cristerna crystal, we'll chat about that later. Genuine rubber strap, and I guess that's one of the issues I like to bring up here, is because there are so many varying degrees of quality with rubber straps. There are some that just kind of feel like plastic, and you wouldn't want them in contact with your wrist. This is a very soft, very subtle, supple rubber strap. Subtle on the wrist, probably, because you don't feel like you have this heavy, suffocating strap on. And in fact, speaking of, let me just weigh this quickly, because this is going to come in at 101 grams, 101 grams in weight. So it is something that you can wear comfortably all day long and not feel like you have this brick of stainless steel on your wrist all day. V91304, 4 color choices. Again, strap color, dial color. That's the combination that you're asking for when you order. Obviously, there will be some other variables there as well. V91304. We will leave that one and let you know about our pocket watch coming up later on in the show. This is the neatest item And, oh, I didn't know this, we have barely a dozen remaining. So that has been a very popular item this weekend. If you're still interested, $143.25. Mechanical movement on that one.
And you were just talking about Father's Day. I mean, come on.
Oh, awesome, Larry. Yeah. Oh, perfect idea. Perfect idea right there. B91509. And also later on, we have, I have promised you ladies that you'd be able to participate. Actually, a number of you are buying men's watches anyways, but if you want something with some sparkle, there you have a lady, Marina, sports watch, $99.41. The wonderful thing about the Stuhrling line maybe exemplifies better than just about any other watch brand out there, something for everybody. We've got a pocket watch. We have watches for the ladies. We have something for the more conservatively styled man. Coming up, in fact, in a little bit, we have a probably my favorite dual-time watch that Stuhrling has ever made. You'll be seeing that. But now, something very modern, very contemporary. In fact, the name Gen X Sport Multifunction kind of hints at that. First visit on five value payments. So $29.85 can get this home in a very straightforward choice of blue, brown, or black.
Well, you know, Shawn, this is our Gen X, and it's from our actually our Epiphany collection. And the Gen X for 2009... was one of the biggest model launches we had of the whole year with the original Gen X and then the Gen X Sport. In 2010, in January, we launched the Gen X Sport, and that's what we're seeing right here. But we never did it at a price of this $149. So this is a tremendous opportunity to pick up on our Gen X Sport. It is a 49-millimeter case size, which was the same size as the Gen X Pro. The original was 45. So this is the larger size case at 49. It makes a tremendous presence and statement on the wrist, and I'll be glad to pop one on my wrist here. But what this one's all about, Shawn, really, is the dial work. You have such a three-dimensional dial with just many multiple components and layers. All those hour markers that you see, the nine and then those hour mark, they're three-dimensional in the sense that they come out and then they go down into the dial. It's got great depth in the dial on this piece. You've got a very high cannon pinion in the center that holds your hour, minute, and second hands on the Citizen Miyota JR00 movement. Nice shot, Shawn. But the hour, minutes, and second hands have to clear all those components. You'll notice from, and then look at the three-dimensionality of the numerals there, Shawn. Very well shown what I was just talking about. But that retrograde day of the week indication that goes from 3 o'clock to about 6 o'clock there, it's got a little bridge. And the base dial is done with a Cote de Genève decoration. And as you rotate that slightly up, you'll see that bridge. And in the bridge, it's got an acrylic plate that has the printing for Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. You see the MTW. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And then you've got a hand that goes, it passes underneath the acrylic dial plate inside that bridge. And when it gets to Sunday, it'll snap back to Monday. But what a unique way, rather than just have, you know, a hand just pointing, you've got the dial work on this piece is sensational. And that is what has made the Gen X so popular. And so far, Shawn, in all three models that we've done in this series, they've all had this exact same movement, the JR00 from Citizen Miyota. So that's what this series is all about so far. Eventually, we may go off into a chronograph. But right now, the Gen X Sport, I mean, this is really one of our finest in 2010 so far, Shawn.
I'm going to ask a favor of you, Larry, because we didn't have time yesterday to explain this in great detail. We just kind of mentioned it in passing.
Absolutely.
Talking about this leather strap here.
Oh,
yeah. This is done in a very different fashion. Can you explain this to me once more?
Yeah, definitely so. First of all, the first thing I want to point, well, right now I'll talk what's on the screen.
Yeah.
It's got a padding. And you would refer to it as a quilted padding, except for the fact that there's no stitching going down the center. It's done with a heat seal treatment that creates those pads, a very sporty look. You see the contrast stitching right there with kind of a heat seal quilted padding effect, very sporty. But to me, one of the really nice touches on this strap is right up there at the case integration. And if you feel it with your thumb and forefinger, you'll feel the strong support at the case integration, and that's all custom done. These straps are not off the rack or off the shelf. There, you see, that's a great way to show it. There's an actual insert, a metal steel insert is sewn into the strap for perfect and seamless case integration. It's like a solid end link on a link bracelet, Shawn.
Yeah.
And this is what watchmaking is all about, okay? It forms perfectly to your wrist. You see how it just slopes down like this?
Actually, Larry's holding the one I want to show you because, well, here, okay, yeah, we'll save time to do it this way. On the blue and the, how are you ordering? Blue and black, there's something else that's kind of interesting, and you didn't see it on the brown. Here's the blue version, okay? Great look, great dial, all of that is
similar.
Look
at that blue.
The blue is very, very sharp.
Wow.
But look at the inside of the strap.
Yeah.
Right there, and you'll get the same thing on the black. The black will be red on the inside, so you're going to have this contrast color on the inside of your strap, and that's going to match the contrast stitching that is on the outside of the strap.
You know, with this kind of the payment options that you're offering here, Shawn, this is a great opportunity for everybody to enjoy the Gen X Sport. It's fabulous looking. Find a color that you can work with. It's a great everyday timepiece. You have a super reliable Citizen Miyota JR00 movement on this piece. And look at the presence on the wrist with this 49-millimeter case design. Please, you know, I want everybody to take advantage, and especially new people that have never joined Stuhrling Nation. I want you to have this piece because you're going to be blown away by this.
You know, I hope, gosh, excuse me, I hope you're taking advantage of the five value payments. That is a temporary thing. First time that this has been on five payments. So $29.85 on your major credit card. Great looking watch that is.
It is.
V91, and a great movement, obviously, too. V91463 is your item number. So continue to call in on all of those. Well, it's Fashion Week. So, Johnny has skipped town, so I'll read this one myself. Simply Nina Lambskin Leather Double Handle Drawstring Bag is what you're looking at here. And we have sold, that's the other reason he left town, he didn't want to read that sentence. We've sold more than 1,900 since the launch in February. Fashion Week prices in effect, saving more than 10% off the ShopNBC price. Four value pays, four great colors, black, violet, turquoise, and, nude, one of the color choices. Tune in for Fashion Week Monday at 4 o'clock Eastern Time right here on ShopNBC. So there, I guess we took care of that. 4 o'clock Monday, we presented, and we continue now. Man, could you believe how fast yesterday my host pick, remember that, the Tuskegee?
Yeah.
Gone in a couple minutes. That was completely sold out. Most of them went before we got there. Now, again, I don't have that to show. That is sold out. This is similar, but not identical. So I just don't want there to be any confusion. But if you missed out on the Tuskegee Flyer XL yesterday, this is another chance to get one of those very popular Tuskegee pieces.
Right. This is actually the same model. This is our Tuskegee Bomber, the same as that one. The difference was that one was just a different execution. That one had the luminous dial. Now, this one, now these are two brand new executions for our Tuskegee Bomber. We came out with the first two executions about maybe 3-4 weeks ago. Then we came out with the third execution was the all loom.
And now
these are the last two executions of the Tuskegee Bomber, where you have black dial in orange and black dial in yellow. But this is the newer version now, the Bomber, that is the 52-millimeter case design. And above all, it is a mechanical automatic timepiece. So it's a pilot-style watch with the black PVD case, PVD, physical vapor deposition, okay? And a pilot style, you've got the plume style hour hands, the plume style minute hands. It's from our Bravo Zulu series in our Sportsman's Collection. Very military-inspired type of look to this piece. And our Tuskegee line has just been so popular. It goes back over 3 years, maybe 3.5 years now. And the Bomber now is the newest version in the line, the big 52. And it's got that kind of bomber leather, you know, beaten up leather jacket style of leather strap, Shawn.
That's the other kind of kicker to this deal, is just how well made these straps are, because this is a piece of genuine leather. It's very thick, but still very comfortable on. It's going to feel, in fact, wonderful when you are wearing this. But yes, it is a little bit of a larger watch. 52 millimeter is the case diameter. So if you're looking for something that is going to fit a little bit larger, not massive, you know, there are some out there certainly much, much, much larger, please take advantage of these new choices. We have them in orange and in yellow. Many of you I know already own one. You're now purchasing your second. You're getting some of the different color options. Larry has put one on, so while he does that, I will show you the case back on one of these first, since you won't see that on the wrist. So you can see, for verification purposes, that mechanical automatic movement. Look at the rotor, though, too.
Yeah, it's got a Damier finish on the rotor, which is what is like a net pattern. You see the back plates in the back have the perlage treatment, and then the pillar plate with those parallel lines, that's called a Côte de Genève finish on the movement here. But it is rather remarkable. You're getting a mechanical automatic timepiece that, you know, is fairly well under $100. You're getting this large 52-millimeter presence on the wrist. And let me say this, too. You know, if anybody out there, a lot of the pieces in our Tuskegee line, not all of them, have luminous markers in hands and what have we, have the luminous dial. If you're looking for the luminous, then truthfully, neither one of these executions are going to be for you, okay?
Yeah, true.
Whether it's the yellow or the orange. There's a little bit of luminosity on these, believe it or not. But again, I want to discourage you that if that's your main sticking point, that I want luminous hands and markers, this is not going to be for you.
Okay?
Yeah, so, you know, don't let that stop you, though, because, you know, not all watches have luminous hands and markers, Sean.
That's very true, and honestly, and I was thinking about this the other night afterwards, how often do you really use the luminescent properties on a timepiece? Very, very rarely do you actually need that.
Yeah.
So, but Larry's right. You're purchasing these based on the styles, on the color choices that you're getting, on the very, very aeronautic sort of look here, the pilot sort of timepiece that you're getting. And there is your size. Let me just, this helps sometimes, I want to put a ruler next to this too. Sometimes that helps you just to know. When we say 52 millimeter case diameter, you can see that comes in at about 1 7/8. You add it in the crown, and it's over 2 inches wide.
Now, Sean, most people out there who follow our shows, they know that orange is my favorite color. But I'm going to tell you right now, between these two, if I'm ordering one, I'm taking the one that you've got because...
I'm shocked. I honestly am.
No, because that yellow, I mean, to me, that is a real true canary yellow. I mean, that is bang.
Yeah.
This is an at-a-glance, easy-read timepiece. You just look at it, and instantly you can take in the time. It's very easy to read this timepiece. Now, this orange, this is kind of what I would call a Texas orange. If you're familiar with the University of Texas Longhorns, they have that little bit of burnt orange.
Yes.
Okay? This is like a Texas orange. Okay? It's not that big, you know, circus orange. You know, like, you know, that... big bright circus orange.
I hope somebody isolates that. It's a great moment.
No,
just
but it's a subtle orange, and I like it too. I love the orange, but to me, this yellow, the canary yellow, and look at the contrast stitching, Sean. These are two great. What's so funny? You like my collage?
The fact that you did that. Yes, I love that. That's the highlight of my night so far.
Sometimes there are some oranges that are so bright.
I know what you mean. It's a valid.
It's like you see it, and you think like we're going to the circus.
Yes.
You know, I like this because it's that Texas orange, and that's what I love about it.
He's right. That's why I have to chuckle, is because as silly as it was, it's a valid point.
I only get silly like that with you, Sean.
No, that's not. You, I watched your shows with Jim, and believe me, you have your silly moments with Jim, sure.
I let him get silly. With you, I like to get silly.
V91543. We got seconds remaining here, but I do want to get serious in the final seconds here because this is a new option in the yellow or the orange. Everything else is black, the black case, the black strap, except for the contrast stitching, obviously. The black dial on the back, the rotor, the case back, except for obviously the visible area where you have your sterner crystal on the back. That is also all done in black type. V91543 is your item number here, $83.50. Brand new colors available for today. So I hope that you enjoy it. You are enjoying those, and certainly that would bring out that you're going to enjoy that beautiful new piece. We're staying in kind of a sporty, a little section here, kind of sportier timepieces, and I hope you're liking this. Now we're going to talk about watch movement again. We're going to get into a little more advanced Swiss movement this time. We are going to share with you the Challenger Sport Chronograph for the very first time on four value payments, $56.81. In any of three choices, black, white, and gray, again, rather straightforward. You look at the watch strap, and you have a pretty good idea which one you're going to be getting, the black, the gray, or the white, as you see it left or right on your screen there. The thing that really impressed me, and I mean this, about this timepiece, is how well Stuhrling was able to take a great watch movement, and we'll talk about that, till we're blue in the face, if you like, but do something so innovative, so modern, so different with it. What was it you told me about how long it took to do this? It's taken a while.
Over 2 years.
Years.
Right, this is 2 years in the making, our Challenger timepiece and Challenger series. We just launched a new series, our Challenger series, in our water sports collection with three timepieces, the Challenger, the Challenger Sport, and tonight we launched the Challenger Pro on Jim's Watch Time show. But that one is it's the same. All three have the same watch head, the same exact watch you're looking at right now on your screen. The difference is the original Challenger came on a leather strap. The Challenger Sport that we have right here is on the rubber strap with the steel link. Yeah. And then the new Challenger Pro is an all solid link bracelet.
Okay.
This is a great timepiece. It's been a long time in the works. It's taken a lot of engineering, and it's gone through a lot of phases. And I even posted some renderings and mechanical drawings on the internet forum here that follows ShopNBC.
Okay.
So people could see the early stages. But a lot of work has gone into this, every aspect. The buckle is a new buckle for us that's got that enamel filling. That you see the Stuhrling logo, that's not just, you know, screen printed on there, Shawn. That's actually an enamel fill around that. It's a debossed channel that has enamel filling surrounding that logo. It's a lot of work, a lot of custom work here. Look at the custom molded strap with the logo on it. I don't want to miss the obvious here. You have a Ronda StarTech sports, you know, court chronograph here, 5030D with a 12-hour counter at the 6 o'clock position, which it's kind of behind that minute hand. But Shawn's activating the chronograph. There it goes, and it's got a 12-hour counter here. You see the exposed date wheel going all around, and, of course, the date is going to be inside the 3. You see the 3 right there that's got that little pointer pointing to the 10?
Yeah.
That's going to be your actual date, and the rest of the date wheel is exposed. This has add and split functionality. The debossed bezel is one of the key signature pieces on this, functions on this. It's got a enamel filled with a double wave inlay in that enamel filled bezel. It's got a fancy tooth design. It looks like a ship's wheel. Anyway, a lot to talk about with this
piece,
Shawn.
We don't have the time. I'm sorry.
I know.
Larry and I can do 20 minutes on this watch. Believe me, I'm not exaggerating. But we have to go. We have other things that we're going to share with you. So this has been, I hate to say, kind of underpresented this weekend. It really has deserved a much longer presentation than we've been able to give it. So one of the hidden treasures, I think, still in the Stuhrling inventory.
Definitely.
Then the Monterey Bay is still available. That's all about great price point. A lot of watch, great price point at only $67.26. Take advantage of that. We still have all four choices. Three payments, $22.42. Can get home any one of those four. Actually, we're still kind of staying in the sportier realm of Stuhrling. We've got some very dressy pieces coming up that I'm anxious to get to. But this has a real, I almost get a European kind of style or feel from this one. Now, clearance price. Let me point this out. Clearance price means when these start selling out, they are not coming back. So as these go, that is it. No more inventory. Mm-hmm. Silvertone brown, top of your screen. Rose tone black, bottom left. And silvertone black, bottom right. $89.22 for the Milano watch that we're looking at right here.
Well, Shawn, this is from our Italia series. You were talking about European influence. I think maybe the Milano name might have been a dead giveaway there. But
might have done it.
But it's from our Italia series, and this is a 49-millimeter case design, so it's pretty massive. This is really one of the first timepieces we did where we started to break into the larger sizes about 2 years ago. Now we're doing 49s and 50s and 51s. We have a 53 coming up in this, I don't know if it's this hour or next hour, with our new Enterprise. But really, this was one of the first, if not the first, where we busted into some of these larger sizes. And it's got an Italian influence in the sense that the corner posts, those lugs, they're not lugs, excuse me, but those pillar posts are actually functional. This is what we call a sandwich-style case, where you have a case top, a main case body, and a case back bottom, and all three are sandwiched together. They're being held together by those pillar posts in the four corners, and it's got those kind of hex lugs on top. So you take,
right,
you know, design in you take functionality and incorporate it to the design elements like the Italians like to do in their jewelry, and nobody does it better than the Italians with the jewelry.
Oh, for sure.
So that's what you have here with that Italian influence. And it's got a great presence on the wrist as well, Shawn.
Well, what Larry is describing is what other companies will sometimes do as a look, but there's nothing practical about it. This is holding in place this piece here.
Yep.
Because that's the back of the watch.
Mm-hmm.
This piece here, your case, and of course there's the pillar then running through. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, about 6 different pieces that are all in this little area. You have that duplicated 4 times over. So those are practical. Those are functioning. Many companies will, they'll cut a little hexagon or something into their bezel and make it look like there's a hex screw there, but there isn't actually any practical reason for it, and there isn't a real screw there. Here there is. In fact, I'll show you the case back. You can see the other end of the screw right there, so it doesn't need to go all the way through. Going back to something we mentioned earlier, you'll also see and feel how this rubber strap is integrated. Larry, this always impresses me.
Yeah, and we go to great lengths to do that. These are not just off the rack. They're custom integrated to the case with inserts inside the rubber. I mean, it's a silicone rubber. We make a mold, but it's got like a solid end link on the inside. Mm-hmm. By the way, this has screw down crown. You a little bit unexpected. This is from our Lifestyles collection, Italia series. You'd expect more of a screw down crown coming from our Water Sports collection, but it goes to the make of the timepiece. No one is standing up here or sitting up here saying, take this on a dive or anything like that. But the fact that you have 100 meters water resistance with a screw-down crown, it goes to the make of the timepiece, and it, we also have a Swiss quartz movement in this piece as well. It's from ISA. It's a three-hand quartz with a date.
Larry just hit on two things you don't very often find together, a screw-down crown and a Swiss quartz movement. That's not a usual pairing on a lot of timepieces there, but here it is. 100 meters water resistant, but Larry's right. You're not going to go diving with this. Hey, if it gets wet, if you go into the pool with it, who cares? Wear it to the beach. If you're splashing around in the water, so what?
Look how great this looks with the combination. I do a lot of black and whites, but I'm usually in a tie. Tonight I went with my little Mandarin collar, just for you, Shawn. But, just with the little mock neck here with the black and white thing with the silver tone black, I like this. And this is really, more for, guys in their 20s, maybe 30s. Obviously, I'm a little bit past that, but we won't go, how far. But my point is, I think it looks great. I could pull this off, Shawn.
Yes, you certainly could. Larry, don't throw yourself under the bus like that. I've always, age is an attitude, and
I agree.
You've got a good youthful attitude.
Well, thank you.
Which is what carries you so far.
Well, so do you, and that's why, we're a couple of old-timers up here, but no one would ever know it.
Got that right.
Well, maybe they would, Shawn.
Probably would. They've been watching us on various networks for, half a century, I think. V90914, first payment $22.30. I do have to wrap this one. Oh, one thing I was going to do. I knew I got this out here for a reason, because the case thickness on this, 15 millimeters in thickness. So, yeah, Larry mentioned the case diameter. It's also about 15 millimeters in thickness. So this is going to say, we've got some thin watches coming up, I think, in the second hour. We'll be looking for the opposite of that. We have that coming up as well. Well, Fashion Week underway, and we're now going to share with you the Genealogy Stretch Cotton Jacket with a front belt. Very important differentiation to make. It is brand new today. It's the perfect wear everywhere jacket for summer. I can see why Johnny didn't want to come in. The perfect wear everywhere jacket for summer dressing from the office to weekend events. See, there should be a comma or something in here somewhere. Fashion Week price, saving you more than $20 off the ShopNBC price. Two value pays. Available in three great summer colors. Khaki, coral, and navy. So tune in for Genealogy Fashion DNA Monday at 8 o'clock Eastern right here on ShopNBC. I might have a week of reading things like this. See, there's at least two commas missing from that. So that's what threw me. But anyway, it's a great jacket, and it'll be coming up.
You think Johnny has an easy job. You see that?
I'm done making fun of him. I have a whole new respect after trying to read these stupid things. Here's what and Larry was pointing out last night how I am such a big fan of the Stuhrling classics and so the more conservative pieces. This is my pick. It's not designated as such as host pick. We just don't have the quantity. There's only 35 total between the brown and the white of their Saturnalia. DT dual time, I'm assuming that's what they're talking about.
Yes, it is.
Mm-hmm. Automatic. Your price is $235.25. I'm going to let Larry go to town on this one because there's a lot that needs to be said in a few minutes' time period.
Many people out there are familiar with our Saturnalia. This is the new Saturnalia dual time. New, it's probably maybe 6 months, 8 months in the making, but it's certainly the newer version. This, Shawn, is in the same 45 millimeter case as the Saturnalia and our Brumalia. It's from our boardroom collection, our Labyrinthian series, and the distinguishing characteristic of the Labyrinthian series is the double mill, double step design bezel with that intricate millwork right there is so sophisticated. Yep. And it's just so elegant. Now we take a look at the movement in this piece. Now everybody knows the Saturnalia had that 33 jewel movement with the retrograde day, the retrograde date. Take a look at what we've got here. We've got a 40 jewel mechanical automatic. It's got a retrograde date hand. Take a look at the 6 o'clock position here.
Oh, I love this.
And this is layered in 16 karat rose gold. Now, you talk about a boardroom piece. Take a look at this. At the 6 o'clock position, you see that big arc that's, you know, like looks like a big smile down there?
Yes.
That's your date, your calendar date. You see, right now it's pointing to this, like two, like between one and three. Oh, Shawn is using the.
There we go.
By the way, he's setting it with the recessed pusher. See the little tool? You will get that pusher tool. And he's running through the calendar dates. I don't want to spend too much time on the date.
I know. I'm moving
Shawn
fast.
Wants to show the retrograde 30. At 31 and snap it back to one.
Okay. Anyway.
Very nicely done. Now, you'll take a look on the dual time. You have a Roman numerals at 9 o'clock with two hands, an hour and a minute hand. And then you have a secondary time zone with two hands, an hour and a minute hand, with the Arabic numerals at 3 o'clock. But here's the kicker now. With all of that operating off of a single mainspring, two time zones, you also had a power reserve indicator at 12 o'clock.
Yep.
A power reserve indicator, one of the more complicated complications to put on a timepiece with a retrograde, with two time zones. It is sensational. 40 jewels. There's no battery in this watch. There is no computer chip. It is amazing. Look at that dial work that you have, that guilloche texturization, kind of almost a Cote de Genève with the horizontal line. Shawn, this is spectacular. Just reel me in. You know, knock me down, slap me down, whatever. I'm getting carried away. This is gorgeous.
Well, we have less than a minute, and that's why I wanted Larry to get out as much information as he could, because he's the expert there. Let me just say right now, you want one of the most expensive looking watches we can show you. People are going to think you spent tens of thousands of dollars watch.
Now, what are we calling it? Rose tone, silver tone, and rose tone brown? I mean, what is it?
Brown or white? You
brown
have
and white by the dial. Take a look at the white. Now, the white is probably going to be a little easier to.
Yeah.
You know, grab attention with and see, because it's, you know, got an easy contrasting here. The brown might be a little richer, perhaps.
Oh,
I don't know, but it's got a nice French leather strap with a crocodile embossing. You got a push button dual deploying clasp. Love it, Shawn. Just love it.
I do too. And you can offset those times. You see, we didn't even have time to explain how you do that. But you'll get instructions that include, because you can set those time zones whatever you want. That's operating off one movement. One movement. Oh, I could. That's another one I could talk about all night long. You're gonna love that V91240. You know, someday, because they force us to move on now. You know, we used to be able to decide if we want to talk about something for 20 minutes. We talked about it for 20 minutes. Now they say, no, guys, you got to move. Some night, I'm just gonna keep talking about the watch that I want to talk about. And they'll put up different things, and I won't care. I'll just keep talking about the watch I want to talk about. We'll see how well that goes over. I do though. I'm serious. V91240. That's you have to grab that Saturnalia. And the Monterey Bay, $67.26. Four great color choices right there. Just go call in on that one. Again, kind of some of the sportier pieces here. The Gen Export Multifunction is $149.24. Three options there. V91463. Actually, if I have to move on, I'm thrilled to get to this next piece, because this is the only Stuhrling pocket watch that we have, and one of two pocket watches in our entire inventory. And what Stuhrling has done, however, for only $143.25, is really done a great homage and a great tip of the hat to the actual antique pocket watches that in my family, I guess it would have been my great-grandfather, or maybe my grandfather would have been alive during the pocket watch era, before the wristwatches came along.
Without a doubt, you know, we're no spring chickens here, Shawn. I can say the same thing. This is from our Montre de Poche series. We started the series, I want to say in August or September of last year, with five different versions, five different models in the series, and I believe this is the fifth and final one that we broke out here. It's taken us about 6-7 months to bring them all out. But this is the Montre de Poche Limoges, and each one of the series in the series is named after a city in France. And in the city of Limoges, they're known for their work with porcelain.
Mm-hmm.
And so this one kind of has the look of a porcelain dial. Now, it's certainly not porcelain.
It would be a lot more money.
Yeah, it would be a lot more money. But it's got that really clean look. kind of those classic Breguet style of hands right there. You do have a dial opening that reveals the balance wheel. You can see it fluttering in the background. But take a look at the exhibition case back. This is the kind of thing that, you know, you'd like to carry in your pocket, carry around and maybe, you know, take it out and show it to your friends and, you know, say, well, let me just check the time. And you pull the time out and you kind of, as you're looking at it, make sure they can see the backside because the backside is very impressive. You have a 17-jewel, you know, pure mechanical, by the way. This is obviously not an automatic. Look at the detailed scroll work. Now, right there is a real nice shot of the barrel that's been cut away where you can see the mainspring right through the barrel. And if Shawn were to actually wind it, you'd actually see that mainspring tighten up. And here's that fluttering, oversized pocket watch balance wheel with the hairspring bobbing up and down. It's beating at 21,000. No, strike that. This one is beating at 18,000 vibrations per hour. Okay, you can see all this highly skeletonized gears. Shawn's winding it for you here.
Just about to do
there
that.
It goes.
Oh,
and you can
I love watching that.
Yeah, you can wind it up. So it really is beautiful. You know, you mentioned Father's Day. This is a great gift item. Pocket watches make great gift items anyway, okay?
You're
but
right.
I think Father's Day, this is really a great piece that you can pass down from generation to generation. And listen, the whole Montre de Poche series has been a big, big hit for us in the last 7 months. And, you know, I'm sure come Christmas time later this year, you know, we'll probably bust out 3 or 4 new ones.
The chain is included. So
yeah.
This is all ready to start wearing. This would go on your belt right there, this little clip. And then the pocket watch could go into your, well, it could literally just go into your slack pocket if you would like, but you might have slacks or a vest that has a specific pocket for a pocket watch. And there's actually different types. If you wanted to, on the internet, you can find different places that sell different types of chains to wear them in different manners. Some people, though, many people are just going to take this off of the chain, and you can, and then it's a desk clock. It's something that you could just have on your desk. It's something that you could just carry around in your briefcase or a bag if you wanted to, so you always have access to the time of day.
And you'll notice, Shawn, it has the small seconds.
Yes.
So it's got an offset secondhand subdial, which, again, in watchmaking, that is referred to as a complication. Simple time is hours, minutes, and seconds. And typically, a complication is anything more than hours, minutes, and seconds. However, when you remove the second hand from the same center, you know, axis, the canon pinion for your hours and minutes, now you've actually created another complication because it takes another gear.
It's down there.
Right. It takes an extra gear. So even though it's hours, minutes, and seconds, it is considered as an extra complication, and it's such a classy thing to do, to do that.
That counterclockwise moving gear is what is, as I look at it now straight on, is moving my second hand clockwise. That is another part of the watch making because my time of day gear for the hour and minute hand is right up there. So you have the relocation of that, the incorporation of some extra gears and some extra work. Hence, on this one, do you know the jewel off the top of your head? It's
see,
not on
my I could just hold it like this. I don't even care what time it is.
You're right.
I don't even care.
I agree.
It's like a piece of jewelry. It's like a collectible thing you stick in your pocket, and you pull it out, and you just look at the the back.
Well, we have a dozen left, so it is going to sell out. V91509. You do get the chain. You can take it off the chain if you would like. It's a stainless steel link chain that you can just go ahead and start using. I love these things. I got to get more pocket. I have 2 pocket watches at home, actual antique pocket watches. They're actually in the repair shop more often than not. This is new. You're not going to have this one in the repair shop anytime soon. I promise you that. That is a wonderful, wonderful piece. Well, again, something for the ladies out there. It is Fashion Week, and so now with all the fashions you're going to be picking up on ShopNBC. In fact, Connie Kunkel will be up in an hour and 15 minutes with some more fashions. The Lady Marina Quartz Leather Strap Watch could be for you. Blue or black are the two choices. Priced at $99.41. I guess my first words here before I let Larry go to town on this are just, this is sized for the ladies. This is not mid-size. This is not unisex. This is a watch, in fact, where's my ruler, whose size really makes this just for the ladies.
Right. This is, I believe, a 35 millimeter case size. Is that what the card says? Yeah, 35 millimeter case size. It does have that debossed bezel with the enamel filling with the inlaid wave pattern. This is from the same series as our Lady Regatta. which we had the Lady Regatta, we have the Regatta La Femme, we have the Lady Clipper, but it's that same series, very, very stylish diver style with a narrower than usual bezel. It is a unidirectional bezel, although it doesn't have a chapter ring on it. And all those little sparkly things, sorry, they're not diamonds, but they are Swarovski crystals. They are very, you know, the finest Austrian crystals you can get. So it's a great functional timepiece from the standpoint of you can dress this thing, you know, wear it out, you know, for an evening wear, but also wear it to the store, pick up the kids. Wear, I mean, this, you're going to get so much wearability out of this, ladies. You really will. It'll be your go-to piece. And, of course, it does have a Swiss movement. So the make of the timepiece is sensational with the solid steel, the Cristerna crystal, which is the most shatter-resistant crystal you're going to find out there. It's proprietary to Stuhrling Original. And then, of course, as I mentioned, the Swiss quartz movement.
Swiss quartz movement right there indicated right above the 6 o'clock position where your date display is located. Ladies, you don't often find a date display on your timepieces, so it's kind of nice when you do have the extra benefit of being able to glance down and see that today is the 10th, and so you can know that as you're going about your day. Blue or black are the two color choices. Maybe the blue is a little more work appropriate, something you're wearing during the daytime. Black, maybe you save for evening wear. I don't know, but now, Mother's Day complete, maybe this is a little belated gift to yourself as we encounter and start a brand new week. But the designing of this really also makes it just for the ladies out there, the way that the whole piece is designed.
I'll tell you what, you know, the more I'm looking at this piece on the screen, I have to get a gift for my daughter right now in L.A.
Oh!
I know she's not watching now. She never watches. Yeah. But this one's got Phyllis's name all over it. I'm getting this one for Phyllis.
Nice the way our family members never watch us. I have one brother who watches me, and that's it.
Oh, really?
That's nobody else ever watches.
When I talked to her, I said, did you see the show?
No.
Oh, Daddy, I missed it. I had to do something important. I went to sleep, you know.
I know.
But anyway, God
always
love her.
Always the way it is.
But she's not watching. But I think I'm looking at this piece, and it just hit me. That's for Phyllis right there.
Well,
the blue one.
And I would bet every guy watching tonight can do the same kind of thing. You can think of a woman in your life, and it could be your daughter, could be your granddaughter, could be a niece, could be somebody you know.
Yeah.
That you look at this watch and say, you know what? That's her. That's her style. That's her personality. Mm-hmm. She would enjoy that for fill in the blank with the occasion that is coming up. One thing I did want to mention, and you see on the case back there, Stuhrling Original, all stainless steel, water resistant, nominal water resistancy, Swiss quartz, but Cristerna crystal, because it's a term we throw out here, and at least once a night I like to explain it, because it's the Stuhrling shows are the only place where you hear us talk about Cristerna crystal, and it's to your benefit.
Yeah, absolutely. Cristerna is proprietary to Stuhrling Original. We were involved in the development of it more than 5 years ago, and at this point, like I say, it is proprietary. It has more strength over a spread surface area than sapphire. It is the most shatter-resistant crystal in the entire watch industry. And prior to Cristerna, we used to use exclusively sapphire, and now it's exclusively Cristerna. Every now and then we do use a sapphire crystal just for the panache of sapphire. If we have a higher price point piece, we had the Imperial Tourbillon earlier tonight where it was a limited edition, but that was almost a $1,000 piece.
Right.
And we put a sapphire crystal. But sapphire crystal is actually more prone to breakage than a Cristerna.
That is very true. That is a fact.
Yeah.
There's something, too. I've had a number of people point out that it's, we Americans, we've got this thing for sapphire crystal that nobody else in the world does. It's just, it's kind of our, I don't know, we have this thing that it has to be a sapphire crystal. No, it doesn't. Most of the world doesn't feel that way. Well, this is for the ladies. It's $99.41 and over 75% off of the retail price point. You're getting a Swiss Ronda movement here. As I mentioned, there is a date display down there at the 6 o'clock position. Nice, easy watch to read, but still a great fashion piece that you can gift for a special occasion coming up or just say to yourself, I like that one. I want to pick that one up, ladies.
I may get her the black one after all.
You know, I don't know her, so you would know her better, but I don't know, they're both good-looking pieces. Is that her personality more?
Well, I think she could use it for dress. You know, the black is a little more elegant.
Oh, there you go. Okay, then problem solved. That makes perfect sense then. Well, now we're going to go from a, 35-millimeter watch up to a little bit larger, a little bit heavier, the Super Apocalypse XT Skeletonized. $194.12. First payment, $64.71. That has been bugging me.
I know.
I'm going to go ahead and weigh this right away. 269 grams in weight. Guys, heaviest watch that we're going to show you all night long.
Yeah, this is hot. This is our super apocalypse.
I love this.
Super apocalypse,
this.
Not XT, but it doesn't matter. The apocalypse series in our Epiphany collection is probably our most popular series that we have in our entire gallery, okay? I think we have about 12 or 13 models in the series now, okay? But this one is the 49-millimeter case size, and we put it on this, you know, this Mambo-supported solid stainless steel link bracelet. This is a pretty thick bracelet, Shawn. It's pretty heavy, too. Mm-hmm. You'll notice the heavy support that it has where, you know, you can't just, it's not flimsy at all. I mean, you can literally hold it by the bracelet here.
Oh, yeah.
And the color executions, I think, are fantastic. Even this black, you notice how it has the little bit of blue accent on the sub-dials there? See it?
I see it now.
It has a real, and here, now Shawn's showing you the blue. I mean, to me, that's your choice right there. I mean, they're both spectacular, but that blue, with that brushed finish on that blue bezel, it's got the signature Stuhrling S screw heads going around, but very, very interesting dial work here in the sense that you have a reveal on the mainspring at 12 o'clock where it's done in kind of a turbine-like fashion where you've got this three-pronged fashion. Of course, the hour hand is kind of blocking it a little bit there, but right through the...
Move it.
There you go. Thank you, Shawn. But right through that reveal, you can actually see the mainspring. And in this case, the mainspring is pretty loose. Now, if Shawn were to wind it up, you would actually, there he goes, you're actually going to see the mainspring tighten up. And that's one of the things I love about this timepiece is you've got a mainspring reveal in the dial to just see the mainspring. And then over to the left, that is where you can see the balance wheel, and it actually, you know, would be beating at 21,600 vibrations per hour. There it goes. I guess we had the crown pulled out?
Yeah, I was messed up.
So okay.
My fault.
Shawn had the crown pulled out, which means it's a hacking move, and he pushed it back in. But also, notice the rest of the dial. It's got that acrylic-tinted dial plate with the blue tint. You can actually see right through it, and you can see parts of the movement. It's got the Stuhrling logo right there. Very clean dial work here with that angled flange. We love this piece, and this case design is really... I have to say it's our most popular case design going right now. It's got these case extensions with the covered lugs on the 12 and 6. It's got case extensions at 3 and 9. It's got the 10-sided bezel, the diagonal bezel with the Stuhrling S screw heads going all the way around. And just as I was going to put it on the wrist, you beat me to it, Shawn. But here's your...
love this thing.
It's awesome.
And I am not one, I've mentioned this before, I'm not one for huge watches, heavy timepieces. I would own this and wear this in a second.
Look how good that looks on you, Shawn, with that shirt you've got.
I'd even wear this with a suit. I would absolutely take this, and I would wear this to work, no problem. Generous bracelet, there are removable links. I'm holding back the excess here, but there are plenty of removable links so you can get that perfect fit. I have a 6 3/4 inch wrist. Fits me fine. I love the blue that is used here. I think that's part of it. The watch movement, it is a hacking movement. We use that term to describe when you saw me pull out the crown. It stopped the movement, and not every mechanical automatic has that feature. Many of them will keep running, even though you've pulled out the crown. This one, you saw it did stop. Now, this is the blue version. Larry has on the black.
I love the black, too, though, because it's got that touch of blue, just a hint of blue. It's kind of an icy blue as well. But look at the size. Now, as Shawn was pointing out, this is pretty generous. I have a size 8. I would say this would easily accommodate up to a 9-inch wrist, maybe even a little beyond that.
Probably, yes.
And you do have a diver's flip-lock safety clasp with a push button for opening as well. But you gave him a shot of the case back, right?
No. Good point.
No, it doesn't matter. I can do it.
I got it right here.
Okay.
I'm busy staring at this. I'm just kind of playing around while Larry's chatting with all of you. And so, indeed, now I have it set up so you can see the case back on this, because that is magnificent. There is your movement, your 20-joule mechanical automatic movement.
Right. It's our ST90089, which is one of our most reliable calibers, Shawn.
Oh, definitely. But look at that blue that's done on the rotor. Even that is carved out a bit. Mm-hmm. So you can see some more of the movement through that. And as that moves, that's what, for those that don't know, that is an add-on to a mechanical watch that means that as you're wearing this, that will wind it for you.
Shawn, you can even see the little ball bearings on the center. We see where the rotor is connected in the center there. Around, if you look inside that little groove, you can actually see the little ball bearings
right
in there.
Inside of there.
Yes, exactly.
This is the kind of fine detailing that you just, well, first of all, you don't see most of the time, but that's the commitment. Actually, you know what? Just hang on that shot for a second, because this is, it's $194.12. I would challenge you to count just the visible parts right now. Think of all the parts that are hidden, all of the screws, all of the pieces of metal, all of the gears, every part that goes into making this watch work. You couldn't do it.
Yeah. Good point, Shawn. Very well said. And on the black version, you do get a black rotor on there for, you know, color coordination. We always try to, you know, really do fine detail on our color executions. And there, on the diver's flip lock, on the blue, you have a blue flip lock safety clasp. And on the black one, you get a black. So, again, you know, this is really one of our finer pieces from
really
our most popular series, our Super Apocalypse. And, you know, before we did the Super Apocalypse on the bracelet, we had the Apocalypse XT, which was on a really nice rubber strap. And so on the Apocalypse XT, from that we went to the bracelet. It went from Apocalypse XT to Super Apocalypse. And somehow we didn't lose the XT in the graphics here. So it's kind of like, a double, redundancy here. You know, Apocalypse, Super XT. So it's just really one. You see what I'm saying, Shawn?
I think so. I don't know.
Nobody in the world would know but me. But, you know, that stuff, you know, drives me crazy.
Of course, it, as it should, Larry, as it should.
Let that go, but, you
yeah,
know.
You should. I am.
But
I'm just
care.
Looking at the watch. I'm taking in so many
it's
different
fantastic.
Parts here. Are these screws holding in these links, or are they pins?
I think they're friction pins. There might be tension pins, I believe.
Okay, so that's what that, okay.
Yeah.
Because sometimes you'll see what looks like a little slot there for a screwdriver. It's not. Some of the pins have those little points at the end.
Yeah. And, you know, again, the craftsmanship on this piece, all the, you know, Swiss engineering and Swiss technology is certainly there. You see the tooling that's going down the center links that Shawn is showing you right here. You see the satin finish on the side. The case is blank from solid 316L steel. Again, it's very hefty. You see the polishing, contrasting polishing finish with the satin finish as well. So all the craftsmanship that we're known for is certainly evident in this timepiece, Shawn.
That really is. That's an amazing one. V91336 is your item number. Well, we are one down. We have one more to go. Another hour of Stuhrling, so I hope that you're going to come right back. I mentioned we had a thin watch. There it is. We have that coming up and a whole lot more. Second hour, final hour for tonight of Stuhrling begins after these words. Watch.
We're stepping up our style during Fashion Week at ShopNBC. With more fashion premieres ever in 1 week. They're the names that are changing the game. ShopNBC is your destination for fun, fresh, and fabulous fashions. Step into stylish jewels this spring with Gem Treasures. Join ShopNBC as we celebrate Gem Treasure's 700th show. Choose from an assortment of trendy colored stones to your classic favorites. Each item is carefully chosen to ensure high quality and exceptional design at an affordable price. It's all during the Gem Treasure's Jubilee on ShopNBC. Express your free-spirited style with One World Fashions. Vintage designs, novelty washes, and eye-catching embellishments. Fun, comfortable, casual chic. You'll look and feel great. One World Fashions, premiering during Fashion Week on ShopNBC. It's smart, it's sensible, it's add and save shipping. The premium way to shop NBC with confidence. Now, when ordering multiple items, pay only one full shipping rate with your order. The rest of your items ship at 50% off regular shipping and handling. That's right, fill up your shopping cart with anything that Shop NBC has to offer and save big time on shipping. You spend time shopping and we'll take care of the rest. Be good to yourself. It's the premium way we exceed all your expectations. It's Shop NBC with confidence.
Larry had to step out for a second. He's ordering that watch for his daughter off on the side here. Knows that she's going to fall in love with that timepiece. So we're going to give Larry just about 2 minutes here to get his order placed on that lady's timepiece before we go any further here with his company. I am going to take you through a look at a few of the watches that we have coming up in this hour. And in fact, we've got some goodies. Final Arm Stuhrling for tonight, the Targa Elite Chronograph at $164.34. Three color choices right here. Again, getting back into some of the sportier watches, but man, that's still one, guys, you can wear with a suit. We'll explain when we get there. Actually, getting back into the executive look, I love this. The Time Traveler Classic Swiss Quartz Watch. $126.25. I don't think I've presented that particular one before. $25.25. High value pace. Now I'm thinking V91220. Actually, this next one I've been mad about since we introduced this. One of my favorites. It on the left has a feature, two of them actually, that we'll explain when we get there. Priced at $114.73 on the Eclipse 2 V90472. First payment, $22.95. Well, I want to invite you, that's right, I forgot we're going to do this first of all. I want to invite you to think about applying for the ShopNBC credit card. If you open a card today and make a purchase of $25 or more, you'll get a $25 statement credit. Now, go to the website, scroll all the way down, find that little credit card icon. That takes you to that page right there where you can apply for the standard ShopNBC Platinum Rewards MasterCard or the ShopNBC credit cards. A few great ways to shop and enjoy all the benefits of that credit card. There's our Facebook link too. But anyway, back into Stuhrling Original Timepieces. Larry,
well,
good to have you back.
Great to be back. Great first hour. And listen, in this hour, we have a tremendous lineup. I'm really excited about the Enterprise, Shawn. That's right. That is sensational.
That.
And so far, you are the only host in ShopNBC that has been able to show it, because we showed it last night at 4 in the morning,
yep.
And now again tonight. And there's a lot of people here in the studio that was talking about that Enterprise. So we're going to see that this hour. Now, here we go with the Ascot Pavilion. This is a great everyday, yep, wear to the office, business casual, business dress timepiece, because it does have a Swiss quartz movement, but it's so light on the wrist. It's so thin. It's so light. It's like it's not even there.
No, Larry's absolutely right.
It's fantastic.
You know what? In fact, you bring up an excellent point. I didn't weigh this last night. I'm going to weigh this, and I'm going to measure the thickness. I think it was 8 millimeters thick.
It was 8, yeah.
It was. Okay, 8 millimeters thick. What did I say in that one last hour? 15? I think we had a 15-millimeter thick watch last hour.
Yeah, the Milano.
And the Milano, that's what it was. Exactly right. Good memory. So this is about half of what you saw on that one, meaning you might wear this with a suit. You'll wear this with long sleeves, situations where the Milano wouldn't work. Actually, there's an amazing shot of the dial. I digress for just a second, because the dial work on this is so beautiful, Larry.
Right, and all those indices that you see going around, those isosceles triangle markers with the Arabic 12 and 6, those are all applied to the dial. They're not printed on the dial or embossed on the dial. They're actually applied to the dial by hand. And then you even see it's got the 24-hour, you know, the military time hours going all the way around the dial as well. So if somebody says, well, meet me at 1300. Okay, well, that's 1 o'clock. You see, it's actually pointing to the 13 right there. You know, so that would, of course, be 1 o'clock in the afternoon, that
sure
is. But so it does have the military time. It does have the small seconds. You do have a Swiss movement on this timepiece. But above all, it's from our Ascot Park series in our classic collection, Shawn, which everything about the Ascot Park series is our slim line watches. We've got about a half a dozen models in the series. And the original Ascot, it looks similar to this, but it's a 40-millimeter case. This is the Ascot Pavilion, which is larger. It's a 44, well, 45. We measured it at 45 last night, didn't we?
Good memory.
So 45 millimeters. So it has a little bit more, it's a little bit more contemporary now in today's world, 2009, 2010, with these larger timepieces. And here you have it, super slim, uber slim, Swiss quartz movement, small seconds, great business casual piece, dress piece as well.
Well, it absolutely is. This is, just jeans and a nice polo style shirt, and this is the watch that you're going to wear all summer long. It's that piece that is still very professional, still has a very upscale sort of feel to it. There's something about the, what we call the military format of those hour markers, heavily used in Europe. We're really one of the only countries that doesn't use that in timekeeping as far as train schedules, plane schedules. In fact, even on television, they'll say, tune in for such and such a show at 1400 hours. But we don't do that here. So there's something very European, very exotic about having that on your watches. But here's where I have to turn this and just show you how thin this is.
Yep.
That is 8 millimeters thin.
Yep.
Now think of all that has to be packed into an 8 millimeter case.
Right. And, what you're seeing right there is probably only about 4 to 5 millimeters because it's a tapered case back. So it tapers down in the center. So really, you don't even, that kind of gets
that's
almost,
a good point.
It almost gets like sucked
point.
Down into your wrist. So it wears even slimmer than 8. But here's the black. And looking with my black and white here, Shawn, check this out.
Yeah, the black and actually with what Larry has on, that's perfect. This could be your tuxedo watch, guys. I did this last time. I think it was 4 millimeters. The visible thickness, is about 4 millimeters thick that you're actually seeing there because of the way that this is, it's kind of like a bowl almost, the way that this is designed. Curved lugs, so it fits the wrist comfortably. That starts the curvature on your genuine leather strap. You have a black leather strap with white contrast stitching on either one of these timepieces. Mm-hmm. So this is for those times when you don't want. We weighed a watch last hour at 260, 270 grams, whatever it was. That's fine for the weekends. That's fine for when you're going out for the evening. But you're going to be at work all day long, and you're in, a lot of guys in much more conservative professions, attorneys and the like, where you're in a suit and you have to look your best. It's not an option. You have to look your best. This is the watch that you're going to put on. This weighs 54 grams. Think about that for a second.
Very,
that's
very lightweight.
Nothing.
Very thin. Don't let the price fool you on this piece.
No, don't.
The quality is all there. Very professional timepiece, solid stainless steel, genuine French leather. Movement is a Swiss quartz movement, which is the important thing here. So you have the reliability as well.
One thing we haven't really talked about, and we should, are the quality of these leather straps. Because Stuhrling is making sure that on every part of the watch, the cases, the crystals, we talked about Cristerna crystals, the movements that are used, but even the fine quality of the genuine leather straps that are used are all indicative of Stuhrling original quality standards.
Yeah, the tannery that we use is really one of the finest, that's out there. A lot of the high-end companies are using it, but, there's many different grades of leather that you can purchase, and, I'm not going to, lie. There's actually grades that are even higher than this. But my point is that you wouldn't expect this grade that you're getting anywhere near this price. We're able to get it because of our buying power that we have with our factory and what we're able to achieve here with our partner, ShopNBC. You're actually getting probably 3 or 4 steps higher grade than you would expect at this price point, Shawn. Believe me, because I've seen the cheaper leather straps, and they're like plastic, okay? So you're way, way above that with this.
V91297. We have 2 value pays of $41.75. So another good opportunity, another great opportunity for you to indulge yourself in one of the Stuhrling original timepieces that we're sharing with you this evening as we move forward through not just the dressier pieces. We're going to get back into some of the very sporty, very casual pieces. We have a lot on stainless bracelets, in fact, coming up this hour. It's going to be a quick presentation. I was just informed, and I have to believe part of that. It's just what I was going to say.
This is the hotness right here.
This, and we have the orange, the blue, or the green. I almost said yellow. We did this last night, too. Yeah. But it's green. Orange, blue, or green. Priced at $149.18. And your first payment, $74.59. And we have all three of these great color choices on a brand new, technically new yesterday, mm-hmm. not new today, but new for this visit anyways.
Yeah, this is sensational. Now, they're telling us it's going to be a quick presentation, so I'm going to have to talk fast here, but this is brand spanking new.
Yep.
And I think we'll have it maybe tomorrow night with Jim Skelton, but don't let this get to Jim Skelton. Let's end it right here. If you're watching the show and you can hear my voice, believe me when I tell you, you want this piece. Everybody's
yep.
talking about it. It's 53 millimeters in size, so it's pretty massive. I'm going to show it on the wrist, John. You pick the color for me, whatever you want, whether
no,
you go lime, green.
Orange.
Okay, fine. You know, orange is my favorite, and
yeah.
of course, orange is the hotness here. But, Shawn, just feel the quality of
great.
The feel the quality of this silicone rubber strap. It's super high-grade silicone rubber. You've got those anodized steel inserts that you can see the color inserts on the leather on the rubber strap. Perfect case integration, black PVD case. The movement in this piece, the famous Ronda StarTech 5030D, all metal parts, 6 jewels, add and split functionality. Look at the curvature. Shawn's going to show you the curvature of the lugs. Yes, it's 53 millimeters in case size, which is massive, but because of the fantastic curvature of those lugs, it just wraps the wrist perfectly.
It does.
It's so comfortable on the wrist. And
awesome watch movement here, the 5030D Ronda movement.
Look
that you're
at this.
Up. Now, Larry has on the orange
version.
Oh,
my gosh. Look at this.
And he was flipping out over this watch last night. You're flipping out over it again today. It's
well,
obviously a
I'm really,
favorite.
Because I'm doubly excited. I loved it myself when I saw it and everything, but I got even more excited because
seconds,
there are people here in ShopNBC, I can't say the names, that have flat out told me they're ordering one of each color. They
yeah.
love them so much. They see them on the carts going around. They get their employee discount with the codes and everything. They're getting one of each. Everybody is lit up on this piece, which gets me even more fired up. Look at the presence on the wrist, guys. 53, and it's so comfortable. This is the direction of Stuhrling Original. This is where we're going in 2010. We're bringing, you know, brasher, bolder, straight from the hip designs. And look at that anodized bezel. Oh, my goodness. The colors are all spectacular, Shawn. I'm so excited.
I am, too, and I wish we had more than 53 seconds to go here. I'm noticing things that I didn't even catch last night. And I don't know how best to do this, but I'll do it very quickly. Because you can almost count the different levels on the dial here. Because your sub-dials, and in fact, it's also a different texture, too, on the sub-dials. Then you go up one more level to the main portion of the dial. And actually, I could have started down here with the date display. That's down even further. So you have different levels. Then there's this outer track here. That's raised up significantly from the dial. Your hour markers are up, obviously, from that dial portion, which is up from the sub-dials. So there's at least 1, 2, kind of the date, 3, 4 different levels that have gone into this dial here.
Right.
I apologize again for the quick presentation on this, because this is one. Jim will probably show it tonight, and I hope you guys have more time for it, because this is one of the hidden treasures in the inventory right now.
Take a chance, guys.
Yeah.
If you've never owned a Stuhrling or you're Stuhrling Nation, take a chance on this. You won't be sorry. You're going to love it.
I didn't notice, too. Look at the way. I know.
It's fantastic.
I did not notice that on the, I'm just going to say this anyways, on the bezel, the way the numbers are done is even different. You have 20, 25, 30, 50, and 55 marked. And that's it. Everything else is done with a stick marker.
That's cool.
Very, very cool. Ingenious design on that one. Well, onto the Targa Elite Chronograph. And actually, this is one we had a big response to earlier. And so, what's my... yeah, big response. We're down to 58 of these left. We had a lot more than that about 20 hours ago. So 58 divided among the three choices. Silver tone black, all black, and silver tone brown. And in fact, I'll tell you right now, I can break it down even further. There's 19, 18, and 19 left of those three choices. So good luck.
Yeah, well.
Priced at $164.34.
Well, you know, Shawn, what's spectacular here, first of all, this is our Targa Elite. It's from our Targa series in the Sportsman's Collection. Earlier, we were talking about the Monterey Bay from the Concorso series, which is also another auto race inspired. But the Targa series is an auto race inspired series again, different look. One of the, we were talking about genius in design. Well, this particular piece is inspired by a very high end Swiss brand, And many, many, many brands are doing a look similar to this and have been for many years now. And this is Stuhrling Originals' take on this particular look. Maybe you've seen this look out there. But our Target series is definitely one of our more popular series. I think we have a half a dozen models in the series. This is the Elite. Now, the Elite features the Citizen Miyota OS21 two-register chronograph movement in this piece. So you have a very reliable movement. You see, we put that kind of Stuhrling S shape in the subdial over there at the 9 o'clock position. But one of the distinguishing characteristics on this piece, Shawn, is that we call it a criss-cut bezel. It's got the crisscross design going all the way around the bezel. And this was one of the early pieces where we started doing our bronze tones. This is a brown PVD, which gives a bronze tone on that bezel. And you've got the bronze tone links that are going down that angled link bracelet. There's your 24-hour indication over there at the 3 o'clock subdial. But anyway, here's those angled links. Much more expensive to do from a construction standpoint. And feel the liquidity, or you can see the liquidity and movability of this bracelet, the flexibility, as Shawn is, you know, taking this pusher that he has here and just kind of running it up and down and scratching the links. But anyway, no, I'm kidding, Shawn.
I'm not scratching anything.
I just like having fun with you. But guys, really, this is a tremendous opportunity, and really one of the nice things about it in the show tonight is the payment options on the clearance price. Everybody can participate now and actually bring this home. ShopNBC is making it very easy for you to do now.
If I was to pop out one of these pins right there, you'd be able to see that those are all five separate links, not attached together right there at all. So this is the Silvertone Brown. The Silvertone Black is the only other two-tone choice. Larry has just put on his wrist, upside down, mind you.
Oh, yes.
The all-black version of this watch. You did that last night on one of the... It might have been the same watch, actually, now that I think about it.
It might have been, because I put it on, and, you know, I get so excited when I put it on thinking I want it. I put it on as if I'm wearing it for myself.
Right.
But here...
We want you to be able to see it at home. So now Larry will show you the all-black
version.
Look
at this black, though. I mean... Gosh, it looks like $1 million. It feels like ceramic because of the high polished finish.
Good point.
It's not ceramic, of course. It's solid stainless steel with custom molded links. They're all rounded edges and everything. It's got the bugle style pushers, which looks like again something kind of race inspired.
Mm-hmm. There's a couple different features here, I guess, that I want to talk about. And if you're watching yesterday, I'm going to repeat something, but. Many of you watching right now probably weren't up at 5 in the morning watching. There's a quality to this watch that bridges that gap between sporty and dressy. Now, when I think of a chronograph timepiece, I think of somebody who is out for a jog, working out. I think of somebody, a very sports-minded kind of individual. That's who I think of when I think of a chronograph. I don't think of the businessman. I'll tell you right now, I would wear this with a suit in a split second. I wouldn't even think twice about it. I could see guys sitting around. You ever walk into one of those? In New York, you have a lot of those in the Wall Street area where all the brokers at 4:30 head for their cocktails after the market closes. And so you've got some very, very wealthy individuals gathered around. I could see them wearing something like this.
Yeah, it's inspired by a high-end Swiss brand, and basically... it's a very masculine timepiece.
Yeah.
It's got that kind of race-inspired, but at the same time, almost looks like a gauge on an airplane or something like that, too. So, very masculine design here.
You know, and something we mentioned, let me take this off my wrist. It's just a little easier to demonstrate. We mentioned two-eye chronograph. What is that? Three-eye chronograph. What is that? It's referring to the number of these little sub-dials that you have here. This has two eyes, if you will, right down there. Now, I'm actually going to start the chronograph. My large second hand begins ticking away. Now, as that begins to move and as that counts through time, then my minutes will begin to accumulate over in the 9 o'clock position.
That's right.
Your 3 o'clock position is giving me a readout of the time in a 24-hour, a military format, similar to something we mentioned earlier. Now, the thing is, those are your displays. So actually, well, there's a date display at 6 o'clock, so I can't ignore that. You also do have a date display down in the 6 o'clock position. But so, let me stop it and reset it. So now you look at this, and you're saying, well, there is something that is missing that would usually be there. There's no standard seconds display on this watch. That's the other thing.
It's the Citizen Miota OS 21.
Yeah.
And reliable movement on this piece.
And I think that's what makes this a dressier, appropriate watch. The fact that you don't have a constantly running second hand here. And that's all, again, part of this particular watch movement.
Here's the silver and black, too.
See, I'm still all about this brown, the silver tone brown. I think this is just the definitive no-brainer right here. But I know you go for the
Today I was wearing a new suit that I had that's kind of a tan suit. That would have been perfect with that. But I do a lot of black and whites. And, I mean, if you're into the black and whites like I am, take a look at this execution that we're showing you right now. I mean, this is perfect.
That is sharp.
Isn't it?
You can't make a bad choice here. Honestly, you can't. $32.87. Use your major credit card, ShopNBC card perhaps, and enjoy those value pay. Very generous bracelet. I just realized I can slip this on my wrist and slide it right off.
So easily you got a over nice, a 9-inch wrist to handle this. Nine and a half easy.
Boy, that's one of those where I say, I don't know why I don't own that already. I really should. And it's clearance pricing, and it's not coming back when that does sell out. So make note of that. Oh, I hear spotlight music. That means we are going to talk about a sterling silver and freshwater cultured pearl necklace. A 36-inch long strand of them, 10 to 12 millimeters. We have sold over, boy, they're specific too. Listen to this. We have sold over 2,911 of this beautiful necklace. Introductory price, saving you $15 off the shop and leasing price, four value pays. Classic styling, timeless beauty, make it yours today. 2 p.m. Eastern Time, actually, Far East Market right here on ShopNBC will be your chance to pick up on that great necklace. A beautiful opportunity to indulge your love of jewelry in that one. And, in fact, that is going to take us into, actually, a watch that goes back into kind of the classics that we were talking about a few minutes ago. This is the Legacy. We have this in black, brown, blue, or gray. Now, your price is $128.75. First payment, $32.19. These are stunning choices. And I actually am going to ask all of you before you order to take just kind of a second here and examine each one, because I don't want you to kick yourself tomorrow thinking, oh, I should have got the brown. Oh, I should have got the blue. Because, first of all, you can't make a bad choice. They're all so nice for their own reason. I want you to see each one up close and in person. And the first one you're going to see is the gray option, which is kind of unusual.
Mm-hmm. So we're going by strap color, is that it?
I hope
so. Or dial. I guess the strap and dial are pretty much the same color. Strap and dial is the same anyway.
Yes.
But
there's the brown.
This is somewhat of a historical piece for us. I'll tell you why. This is the black.
Yeah.
And then next to it, you have the blue. Now, the blue is a little is the edgiest in the group. In 2010, we're doing a lot of blues, as evidenced earlier tonight by our Midnight Blue Imperial Tourbillon. And you saw, you know, the Super Apocalypse in blue. And we're doing just a lot of blues. Blue is really a hot color in the industry right now. But the reason why this is a historical piece for us, this is from our classic collection, our Heritage Series. And typically, Shawn, what we have done is, as far as anything that comes under that heading of a dress timepiece, about 46 is about as large as we've ever gone prior to this.
Right.
We've got some 45s like our Saturnalia and Brumalia and the DT and all this kind of. And then I think there's one or two in the 46 millimeter range. We really went outside the box with the Legacy Classic. Now, the original Legacy was a 46, which was the biggest. Now we went up to 48 millimeter case diameter on a dress piece. This is where the industry is headed. This is where it's going. I think ShopNBC is leading the way. The ShopNBC is leading everybody into these larger watches, and they're leading us, and we're following, and it's just like this vicious circle. And now, once you go up, it's kind of hard to go back.
Mm-hmm.
I put on some of my watches that I thought were huge at 44, and all of a sudden, you know, I want bigger ones because I'm into the 50s now, you know? So here now we're taking the dress piece all the way up to 48. So if you want to take that dress timepiece into the office and bring it up into 2010, here for 2010, the Legacy Classic, we're really going outside the box. Now, again, I will admit the blue is a little bit edgy for, you know, pure dress piece, but that's also a thing that's happening in the industry now is the blue.
Oh, it absolutely is. Yeah, this is something that you're seeing a lot of. Also, look at this. Here, let me turn it this way. And then look at this dial, because it's fascinating to me anyways. You have this pure, solid color. all the way around most of the dial there. It's just, it's a beautiful kind of metallic, almost sort of blue. Seconds display over at 9 o'clock. But then, just running from about the 53-minute mark down to the 37-minute mark, it's almost like an artistic design of a globe or something.
Yes, it is. It's a texturization, and it actually picks up a little bit from our original legacy. There was a similar texturization, not in the same location, but following in the series. And, you know, the obvious here is this is a mechanical automatic, and it has the small second subdial at 9 o'clock. And, again, as I pointed out before, anytime you take the seconds and remove it from the center axis, when you're talking about a mechanical automatic timepiece, it's actually considered an extra complication. Simple time is hours, minutes, and seconds, but when you remove the seconds, now it's an extra complication. And it's such a classy and elegant choice to take the second hand and put it on its own axis and have an offset second hand subdial. It's just so classy and rich, and it just makes a timepiece, it seems like it's just worth 10 times the price when you have small seconds. It really does.
It is odd, as I sit here and I look down at the blue on my wrist and the black on Larry's wrist.
Look at this.
It is almost like we have two different watches on, but we don't. But you get a more maybe casual contemporary effect with the one that I have on. Whereas I look at Larry's wrist, and you know, I'm expecting a glass of champagne to be in your hand or something with that one.
Or I could be the waiter serving the champagne. But in any case, you know, as I said before, I love black and whites. I do a lot of black and whites. And here we go again. If you're one of those black and white kind of guys, take a look at this execution right here. And, you know, all those hour markers, those Arabic numerals, those are all individually applied. All the hand applications are here. The Stuhrling dial work, the Stuhrling workmanship, the Stuhrling craftsmanship is certainly evident right here. Genuine leather, French leather strap, as you can see here. Solid 316L case, Sean. Beautiful timepiece, Sean.
$3,219. That's one value payment. That's all it's going to cost you to get this watch home. Is that first easy value payment on your major credit card? We have sold hundreds of these since it debuted in February. We have all four color choices still available. I really hope you can add to that savings, the 91409, because that is a big savings to take advantage of all of that. Now we're going to move back from something dressy into something much more on the sporty side. It is the Westport on your screen here. This is still on an intro price. We've had some clearance items. We have some intro price items. Now, a clearance priced item will never go back up in price. It is at clearance pricing. It will sell out at that pricing. An intro price item will eventually go back up. Now, this has not been seen on the network since January of this year, February, March, April, May, so 4 months this has been presented. We're usually hitting the end of intro pricing by about this point here. I don't know for sure, but I'm just speculating. I'm just saying. Silver tone and black, top of your screen, silver tone and rose tone. Left of your screen, black rose tone on the right side of your screen. Yeah. Those are the three choices with an intro price then of $221.91. To get home any one of these three choices.
Well, Sean, this is our Westport, and this is from our Regatta series in our sportsman's collection, our water sports collection, I take that back. But this is truly one of our finer made timepieces. We really went all out on the Westport. So much to talk about with this piece. This is the Citizen Miyota OS22 movement in this timepiece. We're going to demonstrate that a little bit for you. It's got it's a chronograph movement, but it also has, you know, chronograph mode, and it's got the simple time mode. We're going to show you how that works. But earlier you were asking me on one of the other pieces, I already forgot which one, about the bracelet. Was it all screws or tension pins? This one, we went all out on this bracelet. This has got screws in the bracelet, but not just for the links. Even the center links that you see the tooling going down the center links, when you take these links apart, the center links are actually screwed into the H links. So this is truly one of our finest made bracelets that we've ever done. We really went all out on the Westport bracelet, a very, very expensive solid stainless steel link bracelet. You will love this. The movement on this piece. Now, again, the Westport is actually inspired by a super high-end Swiss brand. Many of you might recognize the look when you see it. Of course, we've changed the design somewhat to make it our own. But let's take a look here at the dial work. And then, Sean, I'm going to ask you to You don't mind if I give you a little direction, do you?
No, I'm happy. I know what you're going to say, so please. Yeah, I'm happy.
Okay, well, here, you know, this is the Citizen OS 22. Now, I want to bring your attention down to the 6 o'clock position, okay?
Yeah.
And you see that little kind of fan. So here's what Shawn's going to do. He, first of all, he's going to activate the, well, push the bottom pusher one time.
Bottom pusher one time.
And watch that little sub-dial.
Watch that second.
All right, so, right. Now.
There we go.
Okay, so right now Shawn is in chronograph mode. So we're going to stop for a second before we activate the chronograph and say, well, gee, Larry, that's great. I see your 24-hour indicator over there at 3 o'clock. Okay. I see your minute counter over there at 9 o'clock. Mm-hmm. And I see some kind of a thing happening at 6 o'clock. Mm-hmm. But I don't. Where's the seconds? I don't see a second indication on this. You're telling me what a great movement it is, but where's the seconds? Because we're in chronograph mode. Push the bottom pusher one time, and now we go to simple time mode, and now you see the sub-dial at 6 o'clock. That is your seconds.
Yep.
Okay? Now we go to chronograph mode, and now Shawn's going to activate the chronograph, and watch what happens. Okay? You see it has a retrograde, check it out, retrograde tenth of a second indication on the chronograph, and you're timing something. And, you know, if you want to stop it, you go ahead and stop it. We just timed 11.8.
Okay. Yes.
11.8 seconds. So, again, a super movement. This, you don't see this movement very often. It's the Citizen Miota OS 22. Very expensive. And then look at your dial work here. You've got all those, hour markers that are individually applied, you know, to the dial, and then, of course, you've got that dial plate with the functional screws. You see the screws holding it in with a Côte de Genève decoration on that dial plate. This is truly one of our finest, and the executions here, I would say the black and rose is very rich, but this stainless steel in rose tone, Shawn, check it out.
V90910, sadly, again, we're out of time.
Oh,
we have to move
okay.
on. Oh, in fact, they've already handed me this that I have to share with our friends. It's all about the Genealogy Stretch Cotton Jacket with front belt. This is brand new today, and this is that one that I mentioned last hour, the perfect wear everywhere jacket for summer dressing from the office to weekend events. There's a Fashion Week price in effect, which will save you more than 20% off the ShopNBC price. Two value pays, and we have three great summer colors, khaki, coral, and navy. Coral's kind of a sharp one there. Tune in for Genealogy Fashion DNA, Monday, 8 o'clock Eastern Time, right here on ShopNBC. Seeing some great colors this year, not just in watches, but in fashion, but certainly Stuhrling is, as you mentioned, leading the way in 2010 with some of these great new colors, like the blue that you're going to be seeing. But now we're looking back on a piece that you might have seen before. This is on a clearance price. We have the black and brown or the silver tone black. Your price is $149.24 for easy value payments of $37.31 on a great sporty timepiece, but with one of the most, well, two things actually that strike me. The case shape, there's a lot of very cool angles on this, and the amount of detail that has gone into the dial on this one.
Oh, definitely so, and this also has a tinted acrylic dial plate as well. Now, I'm going to go, last night I think I grabbed the brown one to share, but I'm going to put on the red one when we get a chance here. But this was the first timepiece in our entire gallery that we actually, you know, went outside the box a little bit, and we took a Citizen Miota movement on this. This is the caliber 8247. It's got the offset second-hand sub-dial down there at the 5 o'clock, small seconds. As you can see, and it's got the 24-hour indication over there at 9 o'clock. But this is the 21-jewel Citizen Miota movement, which, again, this is a little outside the box for Stuhrling Original. And since the Arbelos, this is the Arbelos, our model 252, we've actually used this movement in two other models. So this is a trend that's coming for us. We're using more and more Citizen mechanicals these days. And the Arbelos is the one that started it all. And, again, also a very race-inspired piece as well, Shawn.
This is wonderful to be able to. I just wanted to get there. I noticed our black and red wasn't moving there. I'm going to get some energy going, some power into this one by winding this
sure.
up. I said black and red, I misspoke. It's silver tone black. I don't want you to get the wrong one. Silver tone black, the other choice, the one that Larry has in his hands right now, the black and brown. But yeah, these are all powered by 21 jewel mechanical automatic movements. I noticed that the S wasn't spinning around. That's your seconds display on these watches.
Okay.
This is the Stuhrling logo that has just a little arrow on the end of it, which
Boy,
is
that
going
red is
to.
Gorgeous.
Yeah, see, now it's moving around there. That is going to point to that one little arrow there, my seconds display.
Yeah, and I just love the red accent on this piece. Here's a nice tight shot, too. And you'll notice that dimpled design on the outer portion of the dial. It kind of conjures up images of those leather steering wheel covers with the dimples in it. You know, remember
yes.
those? I used to have
yes.
one of those.
I think I did too, actually, now that I think about it.
You used to wrap that kind of stuff around the handle of your baseball bats to get a better grip, you know?
I had a fake fur wheel cover at one point in my teenage years.
I can see you doing the fake fur, you know?
Look, what was I think? What was 1980-something? So what were any of us thinking back then?
Take a look at the semi-exhibition case back that we did here. I think it's ingenious. We've done it on a few other models, particularly with the Citizen Miyota movements. But this is our Bellos, and I think it's just a real clever choice here to do the semi-exhibition case back. And you can see the screws going, you know, pretty much all the way around the perimeter, so you know it's a screwed-in case back. Now I'm going to turn it over for the camera here a little bit here. There we go. There it is.
Perfect.
And there you see the Arbelos name in here, and there's that kind of, you know, wide open rotor that Miyotas are known for. You see the screws going all the way around the perimeter. Mm-hmm. And then, of course, you know, Shawn, you've got the red one there. You've got the hotness. Although there's nothing wrong with this brown, but that red is just smoking. It's like electric red.
They're both good. Yeah, there's not a bad choice really out here, but I am a little biased towards this red and black combo. I keep calling it red and black. I want to make sure you order correctly. It's silver tone black. I want to try and point out something to it. Let me get my little pointer back out here, because this goes back to Stuhrling's ability to manufacture sometimes what you might almost consider a more difficult watch just because of the case design. Now, let's try and count the different angles that we have here and the different planes and surfaces, because you have one sidewall here, another angle here, there's another angle right here, another one here, mm-hmm. another one here. Go over by the crown. You can see that your crown guards actually 1, 2, 3, 4 separate angles. There might actually be a fifth one down here. So this is and I'm speaking on your behalf, I shouldn't, Larry, but I'm assuming for Stuhrling a more difficult case to manufacture.
Oh, definitely so, and you know, I'm glad you brought that up. It's one of those subtle things that goes unnoticed, because these cases, they're blank from solid bars of steel, but it's not just as simple as, you know, we're going to cut it out of a solid bar of steel. They go, what happens is, Shawn, to get all those facets on the thing, it goes through about 30 steps in the process where it heats it up to it's red hot, it's die cut out of the bar of steel, then it's cooled and polished and cut again and again and again, and it goes through about 30 different steps in the process to make a single case. Now, if you were doing it on the cheap, okay, you'd make a mold, and in one casting, you could cast 200 or 300 cases, and then they polish out the burrs, and it's got air bubbles in it, and then they cover it up. That's what you get with a cheap watch. These are done with respect. Respect for the art and tradition of the Swiss watchmaking legend, and all of these cases are blank from solid bars of steel, and you can feel the heft. And, you know, that's one of the important things when you buy a Stuhrling original. You see it on television, it defies logic with the price, you get it home, and you're even more impressed because you can actually feel it. And many times in television and video, something can look really good, and you can get it home, and you can be fooled, and it's not that great. But with the Stuhrling originals, what you're getting here, you'll be even more impressed, Shawn.
Boy, Larry brings up, we've all had that happen to us. You order something, you're anticipating its arrival, and thinking, oh, goody, this is going to be the day, and it comes, and oh, boy, well, that was a disappointment. I have yet to come across a Stuhrling original timepiece that I've presented to you, and I hope that Larry and I are very fair in our presentations. I hope that we're never over-promising you anything. I've never presented a watch where I've driven home afterwards and thought, boy, what are people going to think when that one arrives? I have been thrilled to death to present every one of these timepieces. So, you know, if Larry and I aren't doing our job, let us know. We're the most open people in the world out here, you know. Say, hey, guys, what were you thinking with that? But, you know, that so far hasn't happened yet. Let's move on to our Traveler Classic. Oh! Speaking of watches, I know you're going to be thrilled when you get them home. This is the Traveler Classic, a world time function on this one that is just kind of cool. It's $126.25. Your first payment of $23.25 is going to get this home. I always think of you, Larry.
Yes.
When I show this watch, because you're the one that, what was it, on one of our dual time watches always said you have one offset to France or something for no real reason.
I do that with our emperor.
Yeah, with the emperor.
I always said that six hours ahead, and so that I could say, oh, look, it's 3 o'clock in the morning in Paris.
Yeah, exactly. Well, now you can amaze your friends, as you point out, all of these many different locations around the world. Uh-huh. You've got New York, Chicago, Denver, Los Angeles, Anchorage. They're all printed off there.
Sure.
To give you an idea what time it is in all of those different places. So now, Larry, I could say to you, did you know it is 1,300 hours in Karachi?
No, I didn't know that, but have these been actually set?
I don't know.
The thing about the time traveler, now this is the new version. This is the time traveler. Our original traveler that we had for maybe 3 years or so was such a big seller. What we did now with the time traveler is we went larger. This is a 44-millimeter design. The original was a 40, okay? And this particular movement is by Rhonda. And what we like about this movement is that you set it one time.
Yep.
Just set it when you set your watch. You can set it by using maybe New York and L.A.
And this is set correctly.
Okay.
So
you use it as your New York and L.A. to set it. And then once you set it one time, you're done.
Yeah.
That's it. You never have to rotate a bezel or rotate a flange to gauge the world time.
It's almost 2 o'clock in the central time zone now, which is Chicago.
That's right.
So that means it's almost 3 o'clock in New York, almost 4 in Caracas, almost 5 in Rio de Janeiro.
Paris is at 9 o'clock. What time is it in Paris? It's got a 9 over there.
Right there. So there. Yeah, as you can see.
It's 9 a.m. in Paris.
So as your time progresses, that wheel
will turn.
Moves.
That's right.
So what this movement is doing is giving you the time of day in all of these different places. Now, you don't have to be a world traveler to appreciate that.
Right.
But this movement, because you got to think about how unique this movement is. This is not a watch movement that we have seen, or let me rephrase this. This is not a way of displaying the time in just two locations. It's displaying the current time in 24 different locations.
Right, the 24 major time zones around the world. And this is the new design that's up to a 44 millimeter. So very contemporary, very current, very classy. We have a nice design on the case back as well. Here we go. I'm going to show that to you.
And okay,
very,
we'll go
very
to the phones.
Elegant.
Paul, good evening. How are you?
Shawn, Larry, it's nice to speak to you tonight. Thank you for talking to me.
Hello,
great
Paul.
To chat with you,
good
Paul.
Evening.
Hey, Larry, I just wanted to tell you that I've been watching you for quite a while now, and tonight was the night I pulled the trigger, and I've got my first Stuhrling.
Fantastic. What'd you get?
Well, I got the Targa, and I got it in the brown, the silver tone brown.
Fantastic. You're going to love it.
I'll tell you what, I absolutely love it. I want to compliment ShopNBC. I've bought several watches from several vendors, and their service is impeccable. Every single thing I've ever bought has been beautiful, but this Targa, I'm sitting up here in the middle of the night, and I just had to have it.
Oh, that's great to hear. Welcome aboard to Stuhrling Nation, Paul.
Well, I appreciate it. Thank you very much, and I'm hoping it's just one of many, because these things are addictive. I've got more of these things than I really need, but that's okay. If that's my biggest vice, I'm all right.
Yeah, you know, good point, especially you're calling from Nevada, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, many worse vices you could find out there to get yourself in trouble.
I've had a few of them and divorced a couple of them.
More information than we want to know. Don't go crazy here, Paul.
I like Paul. Paul's a good guy in my book. Well, Paul, I can look at my time traveler watch and figure that it's, about 11:41 out there right now. So I hope you can stay up with us for a little bit longer, okay?
Yes, sir. I appreciate it, and thank you for all you guys do.
Have a great evening.
Thank you, Paul.
Take care, Paul. I like Paul. $126.25 is your price. First payment, $25.25. I like this watch. This is one that's just spectacular. Three great color choices here. I'm leaning silver tone on this one, honestly, though. They're
that's
all
hot.
Good, though. Well, continue to call in on the time traveler. But we've got 15 minutes remaining here in Stuhrling Original Timepieces. Then it's Fashion Week at ShopNBC, so you're going to have a lot of fashion shows throughout this week. And that means Connie Kunkel coming up next hour with a look at
It's our backup dancers. Ready, girls?
Do a soft shoe. Come on. Here we go.
All right, everybody. We've got today's top value coming up. Can you do a time step, girls? Anyway, this is today's top value, the best value of the day, because it is Fashion Week, where we're going to bring you brand new, fabulous, hot fashions for spring and summer. This outfit, you have two color choices. I'm wearing the black with the multicolor that you can see in kind of earth tones with a little dash of the turquoise. We also have the chocolate brown version with the pink. Now, they're under $30, and we also have some solid tops also that can go with this. It is the easiest, most comfortable outfit. It is flattering. There's princess seams and comfortable, and look at this, stretch. So you're going to have a good time shopping with us. We've got handbags. We've got shoes. We've got sunglasses. We've got something for everybody coming up in the next hour with fabulous fashions and today's top value.
I was going to say Patty, Maxine, and Laverne, but that's such an obscure reference for most people. They have no idea who I'm talking about. So. Thank you, Connie. You know who I'm talking about? Patty, Maxine, Laverne?
Not
Andrew's sisters.
Oh, I should know that. I collect that stuff.
I'm embarrassed. I know that. Actually, this should be gone. This next watch, I'm very surprised, is not sold out. It is the Uptown.
It's
going to
be gone now.
XL.
We're not that deep here.
Actually, what did you say, Amy? I'm sorry. Two left in the black. Okay, that doesn't surprise me because Larry and I had this last night and sold through tons of these. Clearance price on the Uptown Aussie XL. $94.14. First payment, $23.53.
Well, you know, Sean, this is from our Lifestyles collection, and it's the Uptown Aussie XL Elite because it's the one on the bracelet. It's a 7-row individual link bracelet. They're all individually custom molded. Now, this has a Swiss Ronda movement in it, but it's not just three hands and a date, okay? It's three hands and a day and date, but not just day and date. It's a bilingual day and date with French and English. But this is the new version, the XL, which is 50 millimeters from 12 to 6. And what we did, because we went 5 millimeters larger than the regular Uptown Aussie, the original Uptown, we curved the case. So you now have a curved case, and there's Lundi, okay, for Monday. And there's Tuesday.
It's Tuesday. Whichever one you leave it in, that's the one it'll stay in.
There's
so if you want to leave it in French, I would push the crown back in and it'll stay in French.
Really cool.
Or just leave it in English. It'll stay in English.
Right. I was going to grab one here, but they're telling me the black is pretty much
done.
This one. All right. You sure?
Yes.
You don't want to take it?
No. I wore that one
before I put it on my wrist.
2 hours yesterday.
Before I put it on my wrist, I do want to show the curvature of the case, because when you have a piece this large, it's important, especially in a rectangular case, that you have a curvature. Let me give you a little background here so you don't see my black coat. But you see that curvature of the case right there? Just enough for the wrist, excuse me, to make, and you've got a push-button deployant clasp here, the butterfly clasp, to actually, you know, for the bracelet. Beautiful 7-row link bracelet, Sean, and you've got the guilloche. Now, this particular look is a very popular look. Now, you could wear it loose like this. Some guys like that. I like it a little bit tighter than that.
Yeah.
But, you know, like a bracelet watch. But look at this, Sean. Just look, okay? Yeah. From one end of the wrist to the other, this is one of the hottest looks in the industry. They call them exploding numerals, made famous by a very high-end Swiss brand. A lot of companies are doing their take on this look with either pastels or earth tones. We've gone with jewel tone numerals. But what we've done is we've added a guilloche soleil pattern, which is a sunray texturization on the dial, which is, you know, vintage sterling, of course. But then you've got that double or triple step design bezel. There's all those little individual links. This is not one piece going across. And then look at the value that you're getting. We were selling, you know, originally the Uptown Aussie XL, not the Elite, on the strap for, I think, $99. Here you're getting the XL Elite, the steel bracelet, solid link bracelet, Sean, you know, for under $100. This is truly a spectacular hidden jewel tonight, Sean.
Oh, it is. It absolutely is.
Don't pass this up, guys.
Yeah. There's a very famous Swiss company that does something very similar to this, and it's tens of thousands of dollars for their version.
I did.
You did? Okay, thank you, Connie. Okay. Yes, they are. That's right. They're local. Connie just said she did understand my reference to Patty, Maxine, and Laverne. So, okay, good. I think they're all long dead, but yes, they were very talented for their time period.
I think Connie should just come out here and entertain us because,
she was in our, this is, again, obscure references here, but it's almost 2:40, it's 2:47 in the morning.
She's quite the entertainer.
She was in our host office once singing show tunes.
Oh, God.
And it was the most entertaining, five minutes that I've ever had in the host office.
I would pay. To
people
see
do to okay. see her do that. She's amazing.
I know.
I can't sing a note, so it's forget it. V911, but I can talk about watches until I'm blue in the face, and especially when it's something like the Uptown Aussie. And as I was saying, there's a very famous designer who does something very, and the black is sold out, does something very similar for tens of thousands of dollars. Here you're getting a quartz movement on this particular execution. We've had some of the automatic systems of quartz.
You don't want to miss this, guys, but I'm here to tell you what's going on. This is a spectacular, this is just a steal. I hate to say that in home shopping town. This is a steal, but this really is a spectacular offering right here.
V911-87, I hope
every day.
You've written down that item number. The one choice remaining, the black is sold out. And so I'm assuming now just a few dozen remaining right there in the white version. Well, here we go, wrapping up our Stuhrling original show. We'll talk about the upcoming Stuhrling shows. There are more today, right?
Tonight from 10 to midnight Eastern.
Okay. So tonight, another opportunity. We're talking Monday night now, 10 o'clock Eastern time for a couple hours here. So Larry gets a little bit of a break. I know it's a busy day for you today. Mm-hmm. We appreciate all of that, but for all of you, Monday night will be our next chance. Actually, wrapping things up here with a watch, and I'm glad we've got a few minutes because this takes some explanation. This is not, it's similar to a few tonight. I can't in one sentence really give you the big picture of what you're getting here. Rose tone, gold tone, or silver tone is how you order based on the case. Rose tone has a black dial and a black strap. Gold tone has a white dial and a brown strap. Silver tone has a
brown dial and a brown strap.
I guess it is kind of a brownish dial. I mm-hmm. always hesitate on that, but it is. It's like a brown dial and a brown strap. But whichever one you get, it's all about this watch movement. My opinion, for what it's worth, it's all about the watch movement. Larry may disagree.
Well, I do think the movement plays a big part of this, but like so many of our timepieces, when you have a movement that's unique, it's very important how you dress it up and how you package it. And the design element on this watch, I think, is, I don't know what's more important, the design of the movement, because this is unlike any other timepiece we have. Now, this is our Eclipse 2. It's the original Eclipse was a 40 millimeter. This is the 44, okay? So we went a little bit larger. But it's unlike any other timepiece in our entire gallery in the sense that it looks like a framed piece of art. Now, it looks like, of course, a circular frame, a round frame, but just take a look. Like, you have kind of like the clock subdials on the framed art with a border template, and then you've got this fan over there on the other part of the dial. That is actually a 24-hour indication, and the way that it's done, and this is what Shawn is talking about with the uniqueness of this movement, is you've got the 24 hours are broken into 3 8-hour segments. Usually a 24-hour indication is one 24-hour circle or 2 12s. Well, here you've got 3 different lengths of hands, and if you come in super tight, you will see that the small hand, as Shawn is coming up upon 6 o'clock, it's pointing to the 6, and then it gets to 7, it's pointing to the 7. And now, when it comes around to 8 o'clock, and here it comes for 9 o'clock, here's the second hand coming around that's a little bit longer, and it's going to the center row of those 24 hours. And as Shawn comes up around 1 o'clock, it's at 4, 2 o'clock, it's 14.
Faster.
And then as he comes up to the third segment at 5 p.m., it's at 17. Here's your longer hand pointing to the outer row. So a very unique way of displaying the 24-hour indication. But once again, I say you take a look at the overall design, and it's like art for a wrist. It's like a framed piece of art hanging on a wall, but it's actually on your wrist, Shawn.
Here's something else that, to Larry's point, the way that this is designed and how unique this is, this has a hacking second hand, so I was able to pull out the crown and stop it. And I stopped it in this position for a reason, because here's my second hand. There's the pin that the second hand operates off of up here, where your minute and your hour hand is. Watch how that minute hand runs over the second hand. Mm-hmm. That has to be designed in this manner,
that's
and your
right.
hour hand has to do the same thing, to run over the second hand. That's ingeniously designed.
Absolutely. Very nicely said, Sean. And you do have a date aperture over there.
And that, yes.
At the traditional 8 o'clock position, you actually have the date. So this is our Eclipse 2. You've got those functional screws with the border template. And just take a look at the presence on the wrist. And let's not forget, if we didn't mention it, it is a mechanical automatic too, Sean.
All of that we just described. Four things. Five, really. Hour and minute hand operating off of the one pin, however. Second, your 24-hour display, date display, is all run by a mechanical automatic movement. No battery, no computer chip, nothing else. All run on a mechanical movement. That's my pick right there, the one you've
got. Look at the presence on the wrist, Sean. 44 millimeters. This is from our classic collection. Does it get more boardroomish than this?
No, it does not.
I mean, come on,
absolutely
does not. Go out to dinner with your friends. Wear it for New Year's Eve. Wear this, you know, to a function. I mean, this is going to get looks. This is going to get compliments. And by the way, this is actually inspired by a really, really high-end German brand. Many of you out there know the look that I'm talking about, but there's been probably, you know, a dozen companies that have now taken up this look where you have these intersecting sub-dials, junior main dial and sub-dials, and you've seen this kind of intersecting thing happening, and that's where we get the name Eclipse. But this is Stuhrling Original's take on the Eclipse.
And we love it, and I know you're loving it. The surprise price of $114.73 is in effect. We, right now, are honoring five easy value payments, and that is very important when you consider $22.95 can get home such an executive-looking piece. Looks like you spent thousands of dollars. Let's just call it what it is. When you're wearing something of this caliber, it has a luxury factor to it, especially the pieces with the gold layering. You have, Larry has on the white with the yellow gold layering.
23 karat yellow gold.
And the rose layered piece you're getting?
16 karat rose gold.
Yes. So that, you know, that's the finest right there that you're seeing. You get that beautiful rich rose color. Then with a black dial. There's something kind of striking about that.
Very striking.
They're all very luxurious looking. All inspired by very famous, very upscale designs that Stuhrling Original has done their take on it in a magnificent manner. By the way, and I apologize, it just dawned on me, we haven't mentioned once service after the fact with the Stuhrling warranty.
Right, customer service, our service center is in New York. You have a 2-year international warranty. If anything goes wrong, you're going to send us the watch in New York, and we'll stand behind it like we always do.
Absolutely, I think most of you know that. But for our new viewers, it's important you are aware we're not just showing you the watch and then waving goodbye. Stuhrling is there after the fact. Of course, you have our 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee as well. So please do shop with confidence. It is always such a pleasure. And I did mention this earlier. I'm going to repeat this, though, this time with graphic. We are going to remind you that Stuhrling Original right there. Mechanical strap watch coming up with a surprise price and four easy value payments. So please make sure that you check that out. Returning tonight at 10 p.m. Eastern Time right here on ShopNBC. Tim or Jim?
Jim Skelton.
Jim Skelton, okay. That's always a good time. Larry?
Hey, always a pleasure, Sean.
Always
can't wait to, you know, see you next time.
June, I think, next time we're going to, our paths will cross.
All right.
Now, coming up next hour, Connie is going to be here. She is going to have some fashions for you. Today's Top Value, already been a big seller today. So please join Connie, today's Top Value, and a whole hour of fashions. The shopping continues. You're watching ShopNBC.